Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Now in today's episode, I want to highlight the top 10 tools that you want to consider using, whether you are a service support provider or an online business manager or a virtual assistant. These top 10 tools are my recommendations for where you should start when you want to figure out what to include in your tech stack. So you probably have heard the term tech stack. Tech stack, tech stack, tech stack. It is just a fancy way of your client telling you, here's the technology I use in my business. And here's the thing, oftentimes as service support providers, we don't spend enough time thinking about what tools we should be using in our own business. So I'm gonna make it really, really simple for you today by highlighting the 10 things that I really recommend that you use to really, really kick off a successful service support business. Again, whether you are a virtual assistant, online business manager, graphic designer, these are the things that you really want to make sure you have in your court. So when it comes to the service support professional tech stack, here are my top 10 recommendations. Now, the first one is your project management tool. Project management tools are by large non-negotiable when it comes to running a service support business. And that's because you are always gonna have projects on the go, internally with clients. So you wanna have a project management tool that can help you put those pieces into somewhere so that they're not constantly running in your mind. So one of the things that I often find when I am coaching, especially online business managers, is sometimes when we are getting our businesses going, we sort of deprioritize the things that we need in our business. And I see project management tools as being something that just goes on the bottom of the priority totem pole. And I really want you to really prioritize what you need in your business in order to scale and have a stable business. And this is what I encourage all my clients to do as an online business manager. And this is what I encourage my students who are online business managers to really instill in their business. And that is a project management tool. Actually, if you head on over to sarahnoked.com/tools, I've got all of my tools there for you. In this video, I'm gonna take some time going through each one. So I love Teamwork PM. It is absolutely a great project management tool to have, but there are lots and lots and lots of project management tools in our world. You know, you've got Asana, you've got ClickUp, there's a lot of them. The important thing is just pick one and stick to it. That's my advice. Now, the second thing that I want you to consider as a service support professional is your customer relationship management tool, better known as a CRM. Now, CRMs sound really fancy and you might be thinking to yourself, I don't need that. But the reality is a customer relationship management tool is a place where you literally keep all your customer information. And as online business managers, it is very, very important because there are times when you have a discovery call with a potential client and then weeks and months sometimes go by and you're like, wait a second, who's this person and what do they do and what's their website and where did I save their notes and all that good stuff. So when it comes to a customer relationship management tool, you better make sure that you have something in place. It can be as complicated as Entreport, which is what we use in our business, and as simple as a Google form linked to a spreadsheet that can contain all the information that you want. Now, something that I really recommend new online business managers get started with is something called Dubsado or HoneyBook. Those are two really great options for almost all-in-one customer relationship management. There's a scheduler there as well. You can have contracts signed and you can invoice as well there, and it can do a lot of different things, but that might not be within your budget. Because the other piece is it doesn't need to break the bank to get started as an online service professional. You definitely wanna have a customer relationship management tool that you have in place to keep track of the details of your clients and what they need and all that good stuff. Now, the next tool is your conferencing tool. How are you gonna talk to your clients? I mean, yes, you can pick up the phone and call them, but it's nice to be face-to-face, especially because as online business managers and perhaps the kind of service support professional you are, you know, you're not necessarily meeting your clients in person. I mean, that's definitely one of the perks of being an online business manager. So if you are wanting to have conference calls in the online space, well, you need a good software to do that. And we recommend using Zoom. And I also recommend getting a paid account because the free account only lets you have calls up to 40 minutes. And it can be somewhat silly to get to the end of the 40 minutes and then be like, well, I'm really sorry, but you know, I've got them on a free account. When you're thinking about your tech stack, you want to really kind of think about the budget that you want to put in place for your tech stack. It doesn't have to break the bank. You know, it can be something really simple, but I just want you to have a conferencing tool. You know, it's sort of one of those things where it's part of being the online professional that you are. You want to have a place where you can, you know, provide a link to somebody and they can get on a call with you. They can see you on video. I always recommend my online business managers do their discovery calls sort of as face-to-face as we can get with conference calling, because it does help to instill trust and it helps to really have the right kind of communication, which is an integral part of your client relationship. The fourth big tool, this is a big one, just like the other ones, another big one, is the cloud. Where are you going to save your files? Where are you going to save all of the things? So we love Google Drive. We love the whole Google suite. But when it comes to storage, the two big ones are either Google Drive or Dropbox. They're both great. Again, it's about consistency here. So pick one and actually use it. Make sure that you are leveraging it. Make sure that you are properly saving things. Part of being an online business manager is having an organized business yourself. So making sure when you start with your cloud storage that you have a folder for yourself, you got everything neatly filed there. It's great. It's great to have something like that. So a storage that can live in the cloud is a big part of this, right? Because you're constantly going to be sharing different documents with your client. And also when you're offboarding a team member, you also want to make sure that you can remove permissions very easily. And that's why we love Google Drive. Okay, now the next thing that I want you guys to really, really figure out what you want to use here is your calendar and your email. It usually is hand in hand, you know, whether you are using something like Google or you're using Outlook, it's usually your email and your calendar. So this is the next piece in our business, sarah@sarahnoked.com, @sarahnoked.com. I own that domain. That's my website domain. And that is connected to my Google suite. So I'm able to use my domain as my email address. It syncs with my calendar. I have all my team members using their @sarahnoked.com email address when they're logging into their calendar and when they're using their email, and also when they're creating documents in our Google storage. It's great because that means that I own all of those things and it's very easy for me to remove or enable permissions. And that to me is a lot of peace of mind in my own business. And I really recommend that you think critically about where you want your email address to live and where you, which calendar you're using, because that's a big part of you deciding what you want moving forward as a service support professional. Now, the sixth tool that I want you to be considering is your website hosting. There are lots of website hosts on the market. Right now, we really love working with SiteGround. SiteGround is a great company which allows us to as well as do our website backups through them. They check for spam and they check for malware and all that stuff. So we have a really great setup with SiteGround, and that's what I recommend. You just want to make sure that you research the right one and you find the right place for your website to live, because that's your storefront, right? I don't care what service-based support professional you are, your website is your storefront. So to me, a website is a non-negotiable thing. Like, you must have a website. So whether you are choosing to use something like SiteGround or you're choosing to use something like Wix, which is something where they host it for you, and that can also be a very easy setup. You know, it's actually something that in some of our paid programs we really encourage to create a website using Wix, because you can create a website in a matter of a few hours. But if you are wanting something a little bit robust and to build out something on WordPress, then you're definitely going to need a website host, and for us it's SiteGround. We've been using them for years. The next tool that I recommend is a scheduler. You know, there's a few things that I really recommend that you must have in place, all of these things, but you want to have a scheduler in place. You don't want to utilize the free scheduler, because when you have a paid scheduler, it allows people to pick their time zone. There's a little bit more functionality there. So we love Calendly. That's something that we've been using for years. And again, if you head on over to sarahnoked.com/tools, you can see all of the tools that we recommend. But Calendly is great. It really enables your potential clients, current clients, ease in setting up calls with you. There's none of that back and forth that can be so time consuming, both for you and frustrating for your potential client. It just eliminates all of that. So I do recommend setting up a paid account for these things, because it just allows for more functionality for your potential client and less confusion when they're setting up a call, because they can set their time zone, book the call in their time zone, and wham bam, it's all done. Now, the next tool that we really love using is something like Slack. or what we use Teamwork PM, which is the project management tool I mentioned way at the beginning of this video. So the nice thing about the project management tool that we use is that it has this real-time communication aspect called Teamwork PM Chat, and I really love that. So depending on what you're using, you definitely want to have a place where you can communicate in real time with your team, potentially with your clients. Usually when we're working with OBM clients, we're setting up something that they're using with their team that we're using together with their team, so that if we're forever, whatever reason, offboarded, they still have that system in place. But real-time communication is definitely something that you want to think about in your own business as you're growing, perhaps as you're growing a team and all that good stuff. But real-time communication tools like Slack, like Teamwork Chat are great, 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 and will definitely enable you to have real-time communications with the people that you need to have real-time communications with. The next tool that we recommend leveraging is something for password sharing. Password sharing is critical, right? We want to safely share passwords with our team members and with our clients. So my go-to, literally for the last, I don't know, at least 5 years, has been LastPass. And I use the free account, it's not even a paid account, but I've been using LastPass since the dawn of time, and it's really, really great for encrypting and sharing passwords in a safe, secure way. So when the client comes to me with like a Google Drive of all their passwords and I'm like literally sweating, you know, I can take that, I can safely update and put their passwords into LastPass and show them how we can safely share encrypted passwords that really keep all their information secure, because there's a lot of trolls in the online space. There's a lot of people looking to make a mess of a lot of things that they shouldn't be making a mess of. So this really helps give us all peace of mind and allows us to safely share passwords securely. Now, the last tool that I recommend is time tracking and invoicing. So usually these tools are together. They're not always together, but we really love Harvest. I've used Harvest for a long time. Harvest allows us to track time and invoice our clients. And invoicing and tracking time, to me, are very important pieces of a healthy online service-based professional business, because you really want to be able to bill your clients on time. You should be tracking time. You should be having your team track time from an efficiency standpoint to know where things stand. How are you doing on time? How much time has been taken off of this retainer and all that good stuff. So time tracking and invoicing are my last recommended tool. And again, all of these juicy tools you can find over at sarahnoked.com/tools. We've got all of these resources and some more, but I just wanted to share my top 10 today. It doesn't have to be overly expensive for you to have a solid tech stack. It just takes a lot of thought and consideration at the beginning and consistency in choosing and sticking to what you choose. I can't tell you how many online business managers I work with that will flip-flop between project management tools or spend way too much time figuring out what tool they want to be using when they should just pick one and stick with it, because I promise you, most of these tools are more or less the same. For me, one of the rule of thumb that I use, here's a little OBM tip for the end of this video if you've stuck around this long. So if you've stuck around this long with me, that I do want to give you a tip. When it comes to figuring out your tech stack, you want to figure out what your non-negotiable tech piece is. So for me, I'll give you an example. In my business, I love Entreport. Is it for everybody? No, but I've loved it. I've been using it for years. It's my CRM. It also allows me to like invoice, and it's also my email marketing platform, which we haven't talked about today because it's definitely not in my top 10 for service-based support professionals. However, it's definitely on the list. But when it comes to figuring out your tech stack, you want to figure out what your one non-negotiable is. So it might be something like Google Drive. Google Drive is definitely one of those things that we can't live without in our business. So when it comes to that non-negotiable being Google Drive, I want you to figure out, when you're deciding on the rest of your tech stack, what integrates natively with things like Google Drive, because Google Drive is my non-negotiable. Same with your clients. So if you have a client whose non-negotiable is Dubsado or something else, but like there's a particular tool that they love using and now they want to introduce another piece to their tech stack, you want to first be looking at what natively integrates with that piece of tech in question. And that's going to help you eliminate like 800 other options, because there's a lot of options for software products that you can use in the online space. So I hope this video was really helpful in getting you all sorted with your tech stack. If you enjoyed this, please do hit the subscribe button and click the bell to be notified when we release a new video each and every week. And have a wonderful day, and we'll see you next week.